everyone, this is your sister Neha from Loyola College Visual Communication Department. Let's have a brief study on Indian art. Now we will see what Professor Susan Atti of Visual Communication Department has to say regarding this.
We have a vast history of Indian paintings, architecture, sculpture. Right from 2nd century BC, they say that the Ajanta murals were painted using earthen colors, and the entire history of the Buddhist Jataka was portrayed through these paintings in a chronological order. And then we also have the Ellora caves, which is which are very good examples of Indian sculptures, and the Ellora temple itself is carved out of a single stone. And coming down to south, we have a lot of historical temples done during the various Tamil Nadu kingdoms, like Cholas, the Pallavas, the Pandyas, and the Vijayanagara period, during the Nayaks and all that. We have a lot of very important building heritage sites which attract a lot of tourists from world over. Especially right here in Tamil Nadu, we have the Mamallapuram caves, which are really very important for their basic form of the temple structure. And then we have the Shore Temple again at Mamallapuram, we have Kailasanatha Temple at Kanchipuram, we have the Madurai Meenakshi Temple. And besides the temple construction and the sculpture constructions, we also have a legacy of paintings which right from the 7th century to the 11th century have been recorded on manuscripts. And this manuscript library is housed in the Saraswati Mahal at Tanjavur. So the world's oldest manuscript library is over there. And then we also have paintings done during the Jaina period, very small format paintings. And besides that, we also have the murals as seen, as I told you about the Ajanta period. And there are also very important artists like Raja Ravi Verma. And then we have different schools formed in India, like the Madras School, like the Jesus School of Art in Mumbai, and then we have the Delhi School of Art. So several schools are also there, and there are a group of artists who emerged out of these schools. And in Chennai, if you see, we have the Cholamandalam Artist Village, which is a part of the school as well. And we have a lot of contemporary painters who still keep working very hard in the Indian style. Thank you.
Visual arts encompasses painting, sculpture, those murals, whereas performing arts has theatre and dance. So Indian art, as you know, has been in vogue for many centuries, and art has been practiced in India for many, many years. Now the aesthetic that Indian art applies doesn't apply to the Western world. Visual arts and performing arts in India has its own set of aesthetic principles that it follows, and this is referred to as Indian aesthetics.
Kiran Nadar and an Essex Raza speaks about Indian art which inspires us.
Kiran Nadar is one of India's biggest and most important art collectors. She owns over 3,200 works of art. The works include iconic paintings like S.H. Raza's Saurashtra, M.F. Hussain's Ganga, and F.N. Sousa's Crucifixion. We're with one of India's biggest art collectors, Kiran Nadar, and we're now at the Kiran Nadar Museum of Art in Saket, Delhi. Hello again, Mrs. Nadar.
Hi, Jujan.
Look at the grand entrance to your museum. A huge mushroom cloud of stainless steel. Subodh Gupta's work, Line of Control, in 2008.
I've got a reputation for wanting to get trophy works. So people call me a trophy hunter, which I think is a little unfair, but I do look to get works which reflect the importance in my collection. So I was looking for art for the walls, for the home, and that's how I started collecting. And the first major work, there were three major works that I picked up. The first one was Runners by Rameshwar Bruta, which is in the show at Saket in the Bruta retrospective.
It's in your museum right now.
It's in the museum right now. The second work is a work which is right here in this room, Hussain's Mahabharat. Uh-huh.
The one we're sitting in front of.
The one we're sitting in front of. And the third work is Manjeet Bawa's Our World, which is behind me here.
Students also form their own opinions. And so, let's watch what do they want to tell us.
Well, if you ask me of what Indian artists, I would say the least I know of Indian artists are, well, my history and geography textbooks.
இந்தியன் ஆர்ட் அப்படின்னு சொன்னோடனே எல்லாருக்குமே சாதாரணமாக மனசில் வருது என்னென்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா பெயிண்ட்டு இந்த சிற்பங்கள் இந்த கலைகள்னால் இந்த கோலாட்டம் மயிலாட்டம் முயிலாட்டம் இதை போடுற பல வகையான கலைகள் தான் எல்லாருக்குமே ஞாபகம் வரும்.
பட் அதர் தென் தட் இஃப் யூ ஆஸ்க் மீ எனிதிங் ஆஃப் இந்தியன் ஆர்ட் ஐ வுட் சே நாட் ஜஸ்ட் மீ மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி யங்ஸ்டர்ஸ் வுட் நாட் பீ இன்ட்ரஸ்டட் இன் இந்தியன் ஆர்ட்.
ஸோ அதே போ இன்னும் நிறைய கலைகள் அப்படின்றது பார்த்தீங்கன்னா வந்து இந்த கண்ணு தெரிஞ்சவங்க வந்து பெயிண்ட் பண்ணுறதோ இல்லை சிற்பம் செதுக்கிறதோ அப்படின்றது வந்து ஒரு கலையாக இருந்தாலும் கண் பார்வை இல்லாதவங்க வந்து இப்போ கலர்ன்றது வந்து நம்ம உங்ககிட்ட சொல்கிறேன். இப்போ நான் பிளாக்கு ரெட்டு ப்ளூ க்ரீன் அப்படின்னு சொன்னோம்னா நம்ம பார்க்க நமக்கு தெரியும். ஸோ அதை பார்க்காமலே உணர்றது வந்து அந்த பிளைண்ட்னஸ் அப்படின்ற ஒரு விஷயத்தால் மட்டும்தான் அதை உணர முடியும். ஸோ அப்படிப்பட்டவங்க உண்மையாலே ஒரு கலைஞர்கள் அப்படின்னு நம்ம நமக்கு தெரியுமா தெரியாது தெரியல, ஆனால் உண்மையான கலைஞர்கள் அவங்க தான்.
லெட் மீ என்ரிச் யூ வித் மை கண்டென்ட். Indian art. Art in India had survived in its homeland and spread from time to time all over the world. Many kings who recognized budding talent patronized art and themselves were great connoisseurs. Each king has left a deep impression of his affinity to the artist community. Until today, art is patronized by the rich and famous in the country. Features of Indian art. Spirals and curvaceous lines, vines and tendrils, round figured goddesses, circular amulets, colored gemstones, arches and domes, hallowed deities, crescent moons and the globe of the sun. Sculptures and paintings depict the diversity, color and spontaneity of the country and are representations of the all-encompassing nature of Indian culture. Purpose. Drama and the performing arts serve to generate a rich array of reciprocal benefits for both students and our community. It will help us to improve our skills and prepare us for a professional career. The development and creation of work in the arts use a variety of approaches, styles, media and performance modes, including electronic technology to understand feelings and expression. Objective. Understanding theater as a collaborative art form with social impact. Ability to handle a range of analytical research and practical methodologies in critical studies, playwriting, performance, design and production. Awareness of contemporary developments and controversies within the field. Exercising the interdependence of artistic practice and intellectual knowledge. Motivation. Through some great idea and message, the aim of preserving some of the Indian art forms. Art is a social activity, connecting people with people, and in art there is no right or wrong. Playing with masks leads to the idea of painted mask, so a creative use of colors may be introduced. I would like to sum up telling you all that this project describes the details of Indian art with classification of painting in ancient India, the visible and invisible aspects of art and composition aspects of art. It creates in me a knowledge and appreciation of theatre, dramatic literature and performance in their cultural, historical and interdisciplinary context with special proficiency in at least one area of theatrical endeavour. It also helps us to sum up all the groups who has a passion in arts. This was achieved through the successful establishment of the weekly program conducted in our Palwadi school. I conclude telling you all that traditional art forms, figures and ritual drawing with which an average Indian is conditioned both by participation and observation, exist all through the centuries. Primitive man was unaware of words, but he was able to draw a picture of an animal with a tail, a hand, four legs, or a human figure with a pin head, and simply four lines for his arms and legs for the people to understand. Any figure that is drawn as a part of some ritual composition not only communicates the visual figure in naked lines, balance which unfolds something more than what it symbolizes. So friends, let's keep on inspiring ourselves with the fabulous works of Indian art. Thank you.